Hello YouTube, Temba here. Today we're gonna delete and update in one video, okay? So I hope it's not gonna take long. Okay, we are working with this database and this database test and this table users, okay? Here we go. As you can see, just have three records. So you're gonna start with the update. By the way, this is a continuous of the previous one. If you didn't watch the previous one, I recommend you watch them, okay? So now we want to go for delete the selected one. Okay. Yes, we want to delete the selected one. The moment you click delete, we know that here you have selected something, so we're gonna delete the selected one. Okay, so let's do it. Okay, so here we are testing if the user has selected something on the list box. If there was nothing selected, meaning you cannot click the delete button if you haven't selected anything. That's why I'm going to return the message, no record selected. So now, if there's a record selected, we're going to get the ID, what is it equal to? Sorry about that. So we're gonna get the line that was selected and store it in this ID. But now it's the whole line. It contains the ID, a tab, the username, a tab, and the password. But we only want the ID. So we're gonna say no, it's fine. We're gonna continue. Write this. Like that, okay. So we know we want to substring and store the first, but now you need to trim this, okay? Because maybe that tab is not removed, but maybe I'm gonna show you what I mean. For example, there was a record like tab. Like this, if the record was like this and then you substring here, there's a possibility you just remove this thing here. So there's still a tab remaining here and this actual ID. So the moment you trim it, this tab that is leading there will disappear, okay? So you'll be left with the actual ID that you want here. So now we want to run the command to delete the record. And now, this IT you are looking at here, this IT is not this one here, okay? It's the one that is on your, okay? It's this one here. If you named it identity, whatever, info, even here you must write it in full. But notice that it's an integer. So if it's an integer, you're not going to need this single quote, okay? We are just going to concatenate without the single quote, okay? Now, this ID here is this one here, is the one that I just declared over here, okay? So, don't be confused with these two. This one is from the table itself, it is the name of the column, this one, and then this one is the local variable. I mean, it's this variable which can be accessed by any member in this class, the class of T-form 1, okay? So now we can just execute the statement now like this. But now here put txt, okay? Yeah, let's try and run it and see if it works. Six minutes already. If I haven't selected anything, I click delete, it's gonna tell me no record selected. But if I select, I click delete, you're gonna delete it. Oh, there was a syntax error. You have an error in the syntax. Check the manual console to my SQL server version. Check where ID is equal to 3. Okay, let's break that. That's the nice thing I like. Select SQL here and go to delete. I forgot from. Okay. As you can see, it tells me that the statement must have from. Okay. I just forgot from. So now we can run the application. It should work fine. As you can see, it worked. So the moment I refresh now, you see it's gone. It's no longer there. It's gone, okay? We can now come here and go to browse. You can notice that there's only two records remaining, as you can see. Okay, we are done with delete. Let's go for update now. So here, the delete, we only deleted a row that corresponds to this ID, okay? The ID, we mean the one that was selected on that list box, okay? The user are going to select the whole line here on the list box. Then the moment you click delete, we chop that line, we get the ID, which is the first thing on the list box, the ID. So and then after we chopped the ID, we're going to then delete on the database table. We're going to delete the row corresponding to the one having a similar ID as the one was selected on the list box. That's all you are doing here. Let's click update. Let's just add the update and so that we finish with this. Update like this. Oh, I can't even type. My God, update like this. Good. So now here's update here. So what you're gonna do, you're gonna select an item here. After we selected, we enter new values here. after we enter new values, we click update. So we know that if we click update, you have entered something new here and you have selected the row you want to update. Okay, let's go ahead and do that. So the first thing we're gonna get the username and password there and store it here. Okay, so we have the username and password stored there. So now we're gonna check if the user selected something to update there. Okay, this one is for updating. And then if there was something selected, we get the ID there. After we got the ID, instead of delete, we're no longer delete, we're gonna use update set to be equal to you, and then you say comma, we copy this thing, we put it here. I like copy and paste. I say password, set the password to be P, where the ID is the one that was selected. Let's try and run and see if it works. I will explain it now. Okay, there we go. You can see that this will tell you no record selected for update. Okay, so now I'm gonna select this guy here, Lewis. I'm gonna give him username Sivate and the password Sivate. I click update. Now if I load, you can see everything is Sivate. Okay, I'm gonna name it Sivate 1. I'm gonna name it Temba. I click update. Now if I load, the changes were made. You go to the database table, you refresh, you find the changes there, as you can see. Okay, so update and delete is pretty much simple. So yeah, I guess I have to explain this portion here. You select an item on the list box, you already got the username and password from these two edits here. You got the username and the password, the one that are the updates. Okay, and then you want to check if the user selected something on this box. If not, you want to tell the user did not select anything, else you get the ID from that selected line on that list box. And then now you execute the command update that table, set the username to be the new username here and the password, set it to be the new password here, where the ID matches the one that was selected on the list box. Okay, and then from there you execute. Ladies and gentlemen, thanks for watching, like the video and subscribe. And by the way, all the comments are welcome, and where you think I'm wrong, you can always correct me. Okay, yeah, by the way, you can always contact me. Here's my email address, sivate2@gmail.com. Yeah, thanks guys. We'll continue on the next one. I don't even know what I'm gonna record on the next video, but actually there's something interesting. Just watch the next video, you're gonna see.